Very good evening, everybody, whether you're watching at home on the stream.
If you're doing bucks, you should be at AmeriCup next summer.
Good afternoon and welcome back to Pondsforge International Sports Centre for the Bucks Short Course Swimming Championships 2023. It is day two. We are looking forward now to session number four. It is our Saturday finals. There are going to be 32 races and no less over the next couple of hours. And just over half of those will be for gold medals. We have a collection of B finals in quite a lot of the races as well. I would run through the schedule with you, but it's 32 races long. Trust me, it's a whopper. But we've got plenty of 50 freestyles. We've got 200 breaststrokes. We've got 50 backs, 800 freestyles, 100 butterflies, 50 breaststrokes, 200 backstrokes, 400 IMs, and we end the day on a high with the 4x50 medley freestyle relays. Not medleys, 4x50 freestyle relays. Everything we do, we'll have an open class and the female class as well. And my name's Ewan. I'm going to be talking to you all the way through, as I have done yesterday, and I will be here tomorrow as well. Our officials are just coming to poolside. Our official start time is about 90 seconds away. But we won't hold them to that. The literal seconds, because we're just here to enjoy ourselves. We hope you are too, enjoying yourself at home watching online. Please keep those messages coming in for people that you are supporting. Let us know who you're supporting, when they're racing, and where you're watching from as well, and we'll read out as many as we can as we go throughout the day or the afternoon. I'm predicting a couple of hours for the 32 races, because we do like to make a show of things here. Well, for the medal finals, we'll be announcing each swimmer on in turn, which is a really nice thing to do for these championships. So almost every race, apart from the heat-declared winner events, such as the 800 metres and the 400 individual medleys, everything has got a B final, and that will decide the 11th to 20th in the standings, and then the A final, or the medal final, let's call it, where they'll fight for the top 10, and of course the gold, silver and the bronze. A big thank you to our partners for these championships, New Balance, AmeriCamp and Advicta. Been here all week, you've been having chats with them on the balcony. Seen plenty of you in talks about either having a trip to America and earning $2,000 as a part of America, getting some new personalised kit, or some career advice from Advicta. And we're not hanging around at all here. We've got a big schedule. We're cracking on. This will be the open 50 meter freestyle. Going to start with the B final. One, 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 one. in this B final from lane zero at the bottom. Matt Burton, Rory McKinnon, Henry Baker, Rob Derbyshire, Michael Ripper, Max Elkin, Adrian Ting, Caleb Fox-Jones, Matty Rooney and Chris Muir. So let's get things started. These will decide 11th to 20th. Our B final, first race of 32. And I hope you can join us for every single one. And away we go. Nothing to separate. And through 25 metres, these will be over in a flash. Trust me, we're talking 23 seconds maybe. And back they come. Who's pulling in lane number three? Rob Derbyshire for Bath. Or is it going to be five, Adrian Ting? No, it won't be. It will be Derbyshire for Bath. 22.39. Max Elkin, 22.44. 0.05 of a second. And Rory McKinnon, 22.72. Confirmed in venue. Derbyshire, Elkin, McKinnon. And B final winner. And next will be our first medal race of 16 tonight. 50 metre freestyle open category. Buck's record is 21.4. Set by Andreas Vazeus, that incredible session he'd had back in 2021 for Loughborough. He set six box records that weekend, Andreas Vazeus, across the freestyle, the backstroke and the butterfly. Here we go then, big smiles. From lane zero. Representing Birmingham, Shaquille Giordani. Big cheers for him. In one, representing Swansea, Nathan Chan. In two, for Leeds Beckett, Jordan Cooley. In three, Calvin Fry, representing Loughborough. In four, King's College, Jason Mamatoglu. In five, for Loughborough, Alex Cahoon. In six, for Edinburgh, Tom Carswell. In seven, for Stirling, Brogan Hyde. In eight, for Edinburgh, Bruno Kempster. And in nine, for Swansea, Lewis Fraser. Fraser just staying in his chair right to the last minute. Everybody has a different way of doing things to get them psyched up. And it is literally 20 seconds between them and medals. And potentially medals, of course. Seven will miss out. Got to be at your absolute best. And Mamatoglu was at his best in the heats. 22.01 for King's College earlier on this afternoon. Quick start in nine for Lewis Fraser of Swansea. Also in three, Calvin Fry for Loughborough. He's out in front at 25 metres. Coming back in four, Mamatoglu for King's College. In five, Alex Cahoon for Loughborough. This could be anywhere across five lanes here. Who gets it? Calvin Fry. 21.74. 0.3 of a second. Outside the Bucks record. Lewis Fraser in lane number nine gets a silver for Swansea. And it's a Loughborough golden bronze with Alex Cahoon. 21.92. Jordan Cooley went sub 22 but doesn't get a medal for Leeds Beckett. quality swimming in medal race number one. Next up, two more 50 freestyles. The B final and the medal final for our females. And here are our B finalists. Leading the way there, Charlie Joyce for Bath, Molly Garrett, Manchester Metropolitan, Paige Vander for Stirling, Silky Heisman for Aberdeen, Yasmin Hamerlane, Harriet Watts, Hannah Woodcock for Swansea, Bethany Walker, Sheffield Hallam, Tallulah Paisley representing Brunel, Amy West for Manchester, and Olivia Humphrey, Sheffield Hallam. This is our B final, female 50 metre freestyle. And away, Yasmin Hamerlane for Harriet Watt, 26.23 earlier. She was 100th of a second away from being in the medal final. And she'll lead at 25 metres. In two, looking good. Paige Vander representing Stirling. Her and Yasmin Hamerlane for Harriet Watt going to lead into the wall. Unless in five, can Hannah Woodcock get there? She gets second, Hannah Woodcock, for Swansea. But Yasmin Hamerlane, 25.99. And that would have been 100% good enough to be in that medal final if she'd hit that time earlier today. But it's a win in the B final, a new PB. And if you're watching online, please feel free to drop some messages in. First medal race of the female program coming up tonight. Next, oh, what a tune here in the venue. This is the 50 meter freestyle final. Leading the line in lane zero, that is Loughborough's Clementine Lovell. In one, representing Edinburgh University, Drew McKenzie. In two, representing Swansea, Amy Monks. In three, for Stirling, Evie Davis. In four, representing Loughborough, Camelia Fidovic. In five for Loughborough, Harriet Rogers. In six for Edinburgh, Katie Goodburn. In seven for Bath, Maisie Guildford. In eight for Birmingham, Laura McNabb. And in nine, representing Stirling, Josephine Klein. And there's some Birmingham supporters in here for Laura McNabb. They easily win the noisiest teammates of the week. Box record set last year by Catherine Deloof of Loughborough, 24.23. They got within 0.3 of that earlier today. Camelia Fidkovic and her Loughborough teammate joins her inside the yellow lane ropes. 25 seconds away from crowning another Bucks champion in the short course for 23. And what a start for Vidkovic. She leads her teammate by half a body length through those very early stages. Coming back already, 10 metres out. Keep your eye on the finish line. Keep your eye on the Bucks record here, 24-23. Could it go? 24-40, gold medal Cornelia Fidkovic of Loughborough. And a silver medal her Harriet teammate, 25-08. It's another gold silver for Loughborough. Just outside the Bucks record. And Edinburgh jump on the podium too. Katie Goodburn, 25-10. Well, that's short, sharp work, isn't it? And there's the smile. It's the relief, the exhaustion first, and then the smile. She'll make her way out of the pool. And up next, it is the 200-meter breaststroke races. Open, then female. B final, then medal final. That is four races down already. And our B finalists in the open 200 breast make their way. This will be Arthur Llewellyn for Sheffield Hallam, Josh Mitchell, Edinburgh, Louis Weeks of Bath, Anna in Davies of Swansea, John Britton, Imperial, Pravin Mahendra Kumar, Southampton, Jay Manes, Manchester Metropolitan, Christian Ryan for Bath, Don Bissett for Stirling, and Conor Massey for Aberdeen. John Britton swam a 2:15.31. He goes in lane four. He was the 11th fastest man from this morning's heats. Eight lengths of the short course pool. Waiting for something to separate them. Where John Britton, probably Mahendra Kumar, halfway. It's only Mahendra Kumar sub 30 seconds, 400th the margin from that. But already, John Britton. I mean, on the breaststroke, of course, it's all on your technique and the touch. Sometimes a bit of a conundrum. Do you go for one more stroke or try and ride the wave of the one you're currently on as you reach the timing pad? Can't be split. Britton and Mahendra Kumar, Southampton and Imperial College. Anna in Davies currently occupying third place, and Jay Mann is in fourth. It's the four men in the middle who are 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th fastest from earlier today. And this is pride on the line in the B finals. He'll be gutted to miss out on the medal race. However, you do have an opportunity just to tick another one off and say, yep, I was the best of 10 in that one. And look at this. Once again, almost nothing. I mean, it didn't even look like half a second. Britton and Mahendra Kumar. And it's still Anna in Davies and Jay Manners. Although we're naming a southern, Christian Ryan could potentially come back here and get a top three place. He's going to turn almost with the two aforementioned. But this is about the race at the front. This is the B final. And Pravin Mahendra Kumar of Southampton is going to kick on in the last 5 metres. And he will take it 2:13.23. 0.4 quicker than John Britton. Then Christian Ryan, brilliant last 50 from him, did steal third place away from Jay Manners and Anna in Davies. And you know the routine already. After a B final comes a medal final. And the box record in the 200 breaststroke open category is one of the longest standing. Set in 2015 by Craig Benson, representing Stirling at the time. 2:06.12, which is 5 seconds quicker than any swimmer earlier on today. And here come our finalists in the medal race for the 200 breaststroke open category. At the front there, in the red jersey, that is Edinburgh's Archie Goodburn. He'll go in lane zero. To his left-hand side, two Loughborough athletes, Harvey Freeman and Alexander Casey in one and two. In three, Oxford's Jonathan Rutter. In four, for Loughborough, Greg Butler, fastest earlier today. In five, George Smith for Stirling. Sheffield Hallam, Ryan Griffiths in six. Southern, Rory Dixon for Stirling. In eight, Usain Cook for Edinburgh. And in nine, Olivier Vedrine, representing East Anglia. Some big noise for Sheffield Hallam there, and Ryan Griffiths when his name was called out. Amanda Bradbury on the YouTube chat box is supporting Alexander Casey, lane number two. One of several Loughborough athletes in our 200 breaststroke medal final. Lane zero, Archie Goodburn in the quite unique army camouflage swim shorts. Well, they'll definitely see him out front. He can't hide. Usain Cook, in fact, 0.04ths of a second clear in lane number eight. Going nicely in nine, Olivier Vedrine, East Anglia. And now starting to make his presence felt, Greg Butler for Loughborough in four. He was the fastest by almost 2 seconds this morning. Watch lane number four. He will very likely, slowly, come right back into this one and continue to do so, just maintain the pace while others maybe just fall by the wayside ever so slightly, but he'll take advantage of that. There's still Usain Cook for Edinburgh in eight. Then Greg Butler, Loughborough. Early leader in zero, Archie Goodburn of Edinburgh. Just starting to be eaten up by the pack. And here goes Greg Butler. Final 50 metres. And that's where he takes the lead. Perfect timing. Cook, Smith, Vedrine and Griffiths. Three men now, 25 metres to go, have pulled away from the rest. It's Greg Butler. George Smith has come back for Stirling in five. Where did he come from? In eight, Usain Cook, the early leader, currently occupying the bronze medal position. But in four, Greg Butler, another gold for Loughborough. 2 minutes, 8 seconds, 54. The quickest time of the day. And another gold medal will go around the neck of Greg Butler. And he shakes hands with George Smith from Stirling, who takes the silver, the only two men under 2:10. Bronze for Usain Cook. Admirable swim from the Edinburgh man. Led early days. But when you got the likes of Butler in the pool, you know he's going to be hunting you down. now it is time for the females B final and medal final in that order in the 200 breaststroke. Making their way to poolside. B finalists, 200 breaststroke. Some serious, some smiles. Some having a chat with the officials. Very casual scene. From lane zero, Sophie Payne for Swansea, Caris O'Reilly, Sheffield Hallam. Delise Elena Goku for Manchester. Hannah Bailey, Harriet Watts, Abigail Miles for Sheffield Hallam. Camelia Stoymanova for Swansea. Emily Farr for Surrey. Bath teammates in 7 and 8, Caitlin Hartley and Emily Morgan Hughes. And in 9 for Cambridge, Rebecca Keatley. We can expect a time of around about 2 minutes 30. If they go sub 2:30, that will be pretty impressive. In our medal final earlier on today, we did get down to the pretty low 2:20s actually. Sienna Robinson at 2:22, she'll go lane 4 in the medal race. And Abigail Miles was, there's always got to be one that just misses out on that medal final. Abigail Miles, 11th fastest for Sheffield Hallam. She's in the middle. And she leads that lane number 8, Emily Morgan Hughes, one of our Bath athletes. So in lane number 2, that is Denise Elena Gogu representing Manchester, 2:34 this morning. Abigail Miles, 0.8 clear of Stoymanova and Morgan Hughes, and Caris O'Reilly, Gogu, a few beyond 2 seconds, which will make life a bit difficult in this second half if they're going to compete. Body length lead now towards the final 50. And she had a 2 second lead over several athletes. Now it's just two more within 2 seconds, and Stoymanova and Morgan Hughes a second or so back. But keep your eye on Hannah Bailey here for Harriet Watt in 3. And in lane number 1, Caris O'Reilly, Sheffield Hallam. Not done quite yet. Abigail Miles for Sheffield Hallam. She got a big cheer when her name was announced earlier. Plenty home athletes supporting at poolside, and she'll win the B final. In a time of 2:28.15, I was hoping we might get at least one under 2:30. She's gone way under. Camelia Stoymanova for Swansea second. And Hannah Bailey, Harriet Watt, a 2:31 for third. Next up, medals for the 200 breaststroke. And this is now the medal race for the 200 metre breaststroke female final. From lane zero, Anna Morgan from Edinburgh Napier. In one, Tatiana Bolonigov representing Loughborough. In two, Cara Hanlon for Edinburgh. And a trio of Loughborough athletes in three, four and five. Sophie Hansen, Sienna Robinson. And five, Lily Booker. In lane six, Stirling's Katie Shanahan. In seven, Stirling's Agarad Evans. In eight, Edinburgh's Olwyn Cook. And in nine, Ailsa MacDonald representing Queen Margaret. Margaret. 2:22 was the time set by Sienna Robinson this morning. 2:22:41. The Bucks record was set in 2017. It was Loughborough's Jocelyn Ulliott, a 2:21:16. That is within reach. And they're in and they're away. So Loughborough occupy lanes 3, 4 and 5. And they would love to make it a gold, silver, bronze. Stirling will have something to say about that with Katie Shanahan and Agarad Evans. On the opposite side, Edinburgh's Cara Hanlon. 0.3 of a second just about to Hansen and Hanlon. Early, Lily Booker down in fourth position. Sienna Robinson looking at very good as we approach only halfway, and she's already looking pretty formidable. Sophie Hansen will be in second position, and third, it's still the same order, it's still Hanlon and then Booker, but they're separated by only a few tenths. And she is really at the head of the spear here, isn't she, Sienna Robinson? She's almost making this a one-woman race, still with another 50 metres to come. But the fight behind will be the one to watch. Unless Sophie Hansen, her teammate, not that far behind, 1.67, then Booker, then Hanlon. So now it is a top three for Loughborough. And that is exactly what they would have wanted. And Cara Hanlon is just starting to fall away. In six and seven, Katie Shanahan and Agarad Evans. That Bucks record, 2:21:16. Is it within reach for Sienna Robinson? She's going to take a gold medal 100%. Looks like her teammates are going to join her on the podium too. But can she go below 2:21:16? It'll be close. Yes, she can. By 0.04 of a second, Sienna Robinson, a gold medal, a Bucks record, and a Loughborough 1-2-3 in the 200 breaststroke final. What a race for Loughborough. They've done it a few times in the past, but hang on a second. Sienna Robinson's been DQ'd. Cara Hanlon for Edinburgh will take the gold. So it's not a Bucks record. All drama, and she's a bit confused. Sienna Robinson thought she got it. She's been denied the gold and been denied a Bucks record. Her teammate Lily Booker will be the gold medalist, 2:22:13. Sophie Hansen will be a silver medalist, and Cara Hanlon promoted onto the podium in bronze. Drama in Ponds Forge. Well, we're not sure what that's for. And Siena certainly didn't. But it was up there immediately. I mean, I was watching closely. It didn't look like a false start or... Well, we can't hang around. We've got to get on with it. And this is on to the 50-metre backstroke races. First of all, the open category, the B final. From lane zero, you'll have Leeds Beckett, Francis Dyson, Loughborough's Jacob Goodman, Southampton's James Merrick, Bath's Archie Evans, Loughborough's Jean Lamarisi, in five, Sheffield Hallam's Sam Budd, Cardiff Met, Jack Knight, Leeds Beckett, Matty Rooney, in eight, Manchester Metropolitan, Toby Hill, and in nine, Liverpool's Tom Gambold. This will take around 25 and a half seconds. And between the top 20 fastest times from this morning, which are the B final and the A final, there's less than 2 seconds. That is the fine margin to make it into either the medal final or the B final. Split seconds. Best start from Sam Bird, Sheffield Hallam. He would get a cheer. Great turn from Jean Lamarisi for Loughborough. And they'll go side by side, stroke for stroke. They'll go towards the Lords. Final 5 metres. See it on the big picture. It's a tie. Oh, you don't see that very often. 24.95. I was hesitant to call it because it looked that close. And they do share a fist bump between them. 24.95 for Jean Lamarisi and Sam Budd. I do enjoy a tie. I learned a little while ago, never ever call it if you think it's going to be that close. And thankfully refrained on that occasion. Ah, what a good night we're having already. I say night, it's dark outside, but it's only 4:15. And this is the medal final, 50 back, open category. Let's hope something can split the top swimmers here, even if it's by a hundredth. Out in front there, in the purple with a big H, Sheffield Hallam's Tobias Oglesby. Oh, what a cheer for him. In one, Sheffield's Sam Greenbank. In two, representing Bath, Robbie Hemmings. In three, for Stirling, Zach Speakman. In four, for Birmingham, get ready for a cheer, Ollie Morgan. In five, representing Loughborough, Connor Ferguson. In six, for Edinburgh, Scott Gibson. In seven, representing Warwick University, James LeGrice. In eight, from Bath, Jack Skerry. And in nine, representing Birmingham, here we go again, Shaquille Giordani. They love it. They're right by poolside, just out of your view at the top of the screen. Leaning over the edge. Supporting heartily their Birmingham teammates. And there's a message for Go James, Go Warwick. James LeGrice, Lane Southern. Thanks, Joshua. Keep those messages coming in the YouTube chat box. We're on one stream this afternoon, one pool, and a lot of finals. Ollie Morgan, 24-21 for Birmingham earlier on this morning. The box record, 23-37, set by Andreas Vizeas a couple of years ago. The roof will go off if Birmingham can win this one. He's going to lead into the final 10 metres to his left-hand side. Conor Ferguson representing Loughborough. A little bit too much to do for Scott Gibson, but into the wall. He'll take it by a distance. 23-53. A gold medal for Oliver Morgan and Birmingham. And they love it in the stands. Conor Ferguson will be silver medalist for Loughborough. No, he won't be. Another DQ. Conor Ferguson demoted. He's out of the picture, which means Scott Gibson will be a silver medalist and Zach Speakman for Stirling will take a bronze. But no change at the top. Ollie Morgan, a gold for him. And it is always the caveat, whatever we are calling, we are seeing what you're seeing. When they come up in the red on the pool, that is what we see too. And then only once get confirmation from the officials. It's incredibly rare to get DQs in finals, but two in a couple of races. That is a surprise. Ollie Morgan, your 50-metre champion in the backstroke for 2023. He was just outside the Bucks record too. Only a tenth or so off that. Next up, it is the female competition. B final, 50 back. You may have heard that, just a message for those in the stands. It's, I mean, they're getting very excited. We all are. But the horns, just wait until the race has started. It's very tempting, I'm sure. Okay, B final, 50 backstroke. From lane zero, York's Ella Williams. Edinburgh's Iona Colbert. In two, Harriet Watts, Yasmin Hamelain. Manchester Metropolitan, Molly Garrett, Nottingham's Izzy Lee, Edinburgh's Amy Shields, Swansea's Scarlett Major, Leeds' Abigail Jolly. In eight, Manchester Metropolitan, Amber Ranson, and in nine, Aberdeen's Mary Wood. Every swimmer under 30 seconds wasn't quite enough to get into the medal race. Izzy Lee, 11th fastest this morning, 29.26. In fact, only 44 hundredths of a second separated all 10 swimmers who made it into our B final. So, can anybody go close to sub 28? A quick start in lane two for Yasmin Hamelain of Harriet Watt. To her side in one, Iona Colbert for Edinburgh. Over in six, Scarlett Major for Swansea. Here come in four, Izzy Lee representing Nottingham. But in three, Molly Garrett, Manchester Metropolitan. They're all having a go at this one. Who can take it on the line? It's going to be close to a tie again. Molly Garrett, 28.47. Look at all these times under 29. Molly Garrett takes the B final. Then Scarlett Major, Yasmin Hamelain, Izzy Lee and Iona Colbert. Every single one of them under 29 seconds. And 29.2 made it into the medal final this morning. How quick can we go in this final now? The Bucks record, it's a pretty good one, set by Louise Hansen, 26.47, that was in 2021 for Loughborough. Quickest from this morning, Kiana McInnes, 27.91. But hey, if you're watching last night, you'd have seen some special swimming. And this is our medal race, our female 50 back final. Sterling teammates lead the line. That's Nelly Kinch, she'll be in lane zero. Next door, teammate representing Sterling, Caitlin Ebbage. In two, Loughborough teammates. First up, Honey Osrin. And then in three, that is Sophie De Groot. Sterling in four and five. First up, Kiana McInnes in all blue. In five, Florence Tinsley. In lane six, representing Loughborough, Lauren Cox. In seven, for Edinburgh, Emily Grant. The last couple of stretches. In eight, for Bath, Niamh Ward. One big puff. Almost time to go. And in nine, Manchester, Sophie Shaw. Head down. Concentrate. 30 seconds between one of our 10 finalists and a gold medal and the right to call yourself a Bucks champion. Kiana McInnes for Sterling went fastest, 27.91. Her teammate 0.6 of a second back, Florence Tinsley. They're in the middle. Emily Grant last to rise from the water and get ready. But she starts well. Not as well, though, as Kiana McInnes. But Lauren Cox of Loughborough in lane number six is going to have a big say in this. She actually leads into the last 15 metres. It's going to be between these two. Coming through, Florence Tinsley for Sterling up against her teammate. But in six, Lauren Cox for Loughborough. It's a time of 27.27. It's the quickest time today. It's the gold medal. She may not have realised yet, but she is a Bucks champion in the 50 back. Kiana McInnes of Sterling, fastest this morning, second fastest in the medal final. And then Niamh Ward from lane number eight, a 28.14. She had a great last 25 metres. And they will make their way out of the pool. And coming up next, we go from the sprints right up to the 800 metre races. And these are heat declared winner events, which means we had an earlier heat this morning. But the time, the fastest time for that was 4:22. So that's a provisional gold medal time. Just waiting patiently in the top right-hand corner of your screen. Just waiting for the starting blocks to clear. And now they'll make their way forward. In lane zero, Edinburgh's Arthur Logan. In one, Sterling's Jack Muncy. In two, Swansea's Joseph Deegan. Loughborough in three, four, five and six, Tyler Melbourne-Smith. And Dan Whiffin, Felix Aubeck and Will Bell. Big Loughborough contingent through the entire centre four lanes of the pool. And in lane number seven, that is Swansea's Tom Treblecock. In eight for Sheffield Hallam, Ruben Vista. And in nine, Aberdeen's Cameron Travis. Now somewhere we did have the heat one times. as per yesterday. So much paperwork up here, but I'd like to try and find it to give you an idea of what the times were. To give you some rough idea, the Bucks record is 7:39, but around about 8 minutes is what we're going to be ish looking at. Although Dan Whiffin is the Bucks record holder. He is in lane number four, already a 1500 metre winner yesterday. So who knows what he can do. I mean, that's his record. He could very, very easily break that tonight, I'm sure, considering what he did yesterday. Just a short delay and we'll get things going. Now they're being welcomed to the starting blocks. And off we go. So 30 lengths of the pool. I'll make that 32. Dan Whiffin, not a shock to see him as an early leader. Again, his box record, surrounded by teammates, Tyler Melvin-Smith, Felix Aubex, Will Bell. Plenty of Scottish representatives here, or Scottish universities, Edinburgh, Stirling and Aberdeen in the pool. A couple for Swansea and Sheffield Hallam for Ruben Wiestadt. Now, once again, a big thank you to our partners this week. They've been here and you've been talking to them. New Balance kit provider, giving you the athlete to access a range of bespoke and personalised kits. Also, the New Balance Times Bucks range online at the bucks-shop.com. Quality kit for New Balance. And AmeriCamp offering Bucks athletes the summer of a lifetime and the opportunity to earn 2,000 crisp green dollar bills working at a summer camp in the US, using your skills gained from your sporting background to your advantage. Also get 50 quid off as well if you use the Bucks 50, get that off your program fees. And a placement guarantee as a Bucks athlete. All you've got to do is put your name forward and you're off ski. To find out more, the AmeriCamp, I'm sure they're back here tomorrow. They've left for the day now, but they will be here back tomorrow at americamp.co.uk/Bucks if you just can't wait. And Advicta, our new supporting partner for the short course swimming, is a free careers platform for high achieving student athletes, supporting you with unique job opportunities, professional development resources and career guidance. Speak with the Advicta team and you can create a free profile. You can win some prizes and get going with Advicta today. Don't delay it, or head to ad-victor.com to find out more and develop your employability, which as an athlete is a unique skill trait. Bit of history that you have, you can take advantage of it in your working life. You see around you, many do, many to take inspiration from. And approaching halfway already, if you can believe it. Going to be 16 lengths remaining for our leader. Loughborough's Dan Whiffin. Felix Aubeck, 10 metres back. Another five to another teammate, Tyler Melbourne-Smith. And then in fourth place, Swansea's Joseph Deegan. He's in the green cap, third from bottom. And in lane seven, Tom Trevelcock, his teammate. Swansea and Loughborough, the middle six lanes. But Dan Whiffin looking really good. Is he going to drive on? Still got another day of competition. Tyler Melbourne-Smith will probably know that if he were to make a move on Dan Whiffin here in the pool, then Whiffin's got the ability to just move away again. And they'll have spent hours and hours and many miles swimming together. Tyler Melbourne-Smith is now solidly in third. The race for fourth is between Tom Trevelcock and then in lanes two and one, Joseph Deegan and Jack Muncie representing Stirling. But as the time passes, the gaps between one, two, three and the chase in four just seem to be growing, getting bigger and bigger. So this is going to be a matter of clock watching as we approach the closing stages. 10 lengths to complete, 250 metres. His own Bucks record is 7:39.03. He set it last year in this pool, in this championship. Now, I'm just watching the race for third here, because although Tyler Melbourne-Smith, he's got 5 metres advantage, but Jack Muncie is just looking the one of the three. Just going to maybe inch away, claw into it a little bit. We're running out of time. Only 150 metres to go. Going for two Bucks records in two nights. You absolutely would not bet against it. And as I said yesterday, every year there seems to be, every year in every championship, long course, short course teams, there's always somebody that just steps up and stands a couple of inches taller than everybody else. And they just have a great week. And the gap now between first and second is getting out towards a length. Not quite there, but 20 metres or so. And here come the whistles. We're watching the clock for 7:39.03. That is Dan Whiffin's own Bucks record. He turns in 7:03. It's definitely on. And he'll turn for home. Right, Dan Whiffin going for two Bucks records in two nights. 7:39.03, the time to beat. And he's going to absolutely destroy his own record. 7:30.06. Dan Whiffin, take your hat off to that man. Two nights, two golds, two Bucks records. Phenomenal. Felix Aubeck takes silver, 7:41. And the bronze medal, it'll be all up for again. Tyler Melbourne-Smith, 7:51.69. They take all three steps on the podium. And the rest come in. Missing out on the medals. Joseph Deegan for Swansea, 7:57. Anytime you go sub eight, you're pretty happy. Tom Trebelcock also 1 second back in a 7:58 and half a second over the 8 minute mark. Stirling's Jack Muncie. But Loughborough 1-2-3. Dan Whiffin on top. again. And we do it all again in our female competition, 800 meter freestyle. Looking down the pool, Sophie Main for Edinburgh. That's the way to go. Gonna be spending the next 8.5, 9 minutes in there. From lane zero, Edinburgh, Sophie Main then. In one, UCL's Felida Britton. In two, representing Loughborough, Lucy Hanquit. In three, for Loughborough, Fleur Lewis. How good was she last night? In four, for Bath, Leah Crisp. In five, representing Stirling, Michaela Glenister. In lane six, Amber Keegan, representing Sheffield. In seven, all in pink, Anya Priest, Nottingham Trent. In number eight, Jemima Hall, representing Bath. And in nine, Mari Craig, representing Edinburgh. And that is your lineup for the 800 metre freestyle. Fastest heat declared winner. This is your medal race. And Leah Crisp in four. She holds, just like Dan Whiffen did, and does the box record set last year, representing Bath, 8:24.32. How quick can she go now? Fleur Lewis was brilliant yesterday. She'll be a big, big challenger in this one. Start Crisp, Hanquit, Lewis, Keegan, Priest and Hall, all within 0.66 of a second. Let's not forget last night, Fleur Lewis. It wasn't just a box record in the 1500 metre freestyle where she got the gold. It was a British record. So, if Leah Crisp wanted some competition in this 800 metre final, then she has it. In two, Lucy Hanquit leads for Loughborough though. I just got a feeling this is going to be a good one. Nobody's breaking away. Almost they're just sort of sensing, does somebody want to go? Do you want to go? Shall I go? No, you go. Go on. No, I'm happy. I'm really comfortable. I'm only eight lengths in. Give me a break. Let me just warm up here and then I'll decide. But this could be a classic between Crisp and Lewis and Glenister, Keegan, Hanquit. They are all here for gold. Nobody wants anything else. And on the Box Sport Instagram last night, great picture of Fleur Lewis after she got a British record. And the quite simple statement, a star is born. And in fact, earlier today, it looks like also Faye Rogers in the S10 category. I've got to mention this. Faye Rogers, S10 swimmer in the women's 100 metre butterfly. She swam a 105.14, 100 fly, European record earlier this morning. Wow. So we've now had in the pool, in 2 days of Bucks short course swimming, Bucks records, British records, and European records. What a couple of days. And there's still a full day of competition tomorrow. And we're barely halfway through tonight's competition as well. So back in the pool, Lucy Hanquit. She leads by just over a second, Leah Crisp and Fleur Lewis. I feel like they're just playing with each other at the moment. They're just keeping an eye on things. But Lucy Hanquit could make this a very interesting three-way race. And absolutely not discounting here Glenister and Keegan for Stirling and Sheffield in 5 and 6. Absolutely in this. We are at halfway. So we hit the halfway mark in 4:10. Leah Crisp's record is 8:24.32. So pretty much if they can absolutely maintain this cadence, tempo, pace, call it what you like, we're on for it. And if they leave something in the tank to do a quick last 25 or a quick last 50, we are 100% on. And I just love the fact that this is still so close. Sometimes you get a swimmer that moves away by 5, 10 metres, like the likes of Dan Whiffen did in the last race. But this is going to be very, very fascinating to watch until the absolutely closing laps. Because Leah Crisp is now just half a body length behind Fleur Lewis. The psychological advantage. But Lucy Hanquit leads the way. Could she write the story here? You've got the box record holder in 4. You've got the British record holder in the 1500 metres in lane 3. And Lucy Hanquit leads them both. Is that a grimace? 10 lengths, 250 metres between them right now and a finish line. And there's a gap now to Leah Crisp of Bath. And is Fleur Lewis now deciding this is the time? You've held that lead for long enough. They are teammates. It'll be a competitive but friendly rivalry. But both these girls, all three of them, all five, Glenister and Keegan, are still in this medal battle. But they only want one, and that's the top step of the podium. A gold medal, and the cherry on the top would be the Bucks record, and they're on for it right now. Hanquit, Lewis, Crisp falling off the pace. Will she lose her title? Will she lose her Bucks record? Going to find out in 150 metres time. Don't go anywhere. And the gap is closing. It's 1.12 seconds. And you just get a sense that Fleur Lewis knows exactly what she's doing. Can Lucy Hanquit just maintain the body length? 100 metres between her and a gold medal. She's going to be fought the entire way. Leah Crisp now solidly in bronze, but is not going to be involved in the gold medal fight. That is going to be Loughborough versus Loughborough. is Hanquit versus Lewis. Hanquit holding on. They're going to hear the whistles. They're going to go out and back one more time. And will the whistle be the signal for Fleur Lewis? That now is the moment. It's under a second. It's 0.7. She's taken 6 tenths off it. She has to do the same again. And she's fighting through here. Oh, what a finish we've got. Lucy Hanquit, she's led from the start. She'll lead into the final 25 metres of 800. Or is Fleur Lewis going to spoil her party and come and take a second gold, potentially a second Bucks record? They're going to be 8.24. That's going to be close. The finish is going to be close. It goes to Lucy Hanquit, 8.21.86. It's a gold medal. It's a Bucks record. What a finish. It's hundredths of a second over 800 metres. What a race in the women's 800 metre freestyle. 200ths of a second between gold and silver. It's gold and the Bucks record for Lucy Hanquit. What a swim. I don't think you'll ever see that again. 200ths of a second over 800 metres is absolutely unheard of. And especially teammates too. That's ridiculous. And what a pleasure to watch. Leah Crisps, she gets a bronze representing Bath. Not the one she wanted, but she was involved in a great fight for the first 700. Then Loughborough moved away. I'm so happy to say it's been confirmed on the scoreboard too. I was just dreading a DQ there. Lucy Hanquit, gold medal, 8.21.86. And a Bucks record. Takes it away from Leah Crisp, who finished in the bronze, splitting them. Fleur Lewis, who had a great night last night. And she's followed up with a silver in the 800. You won't top that this weekend. Have you got your breath back? We're going to go again now. There's no hanging around, and rightly so. 100 metre butterfly, B final coming up next. From lane zero, Birmingham Sam Pyefinch, Sheffield Sam Cornish, Edinburgh's Brody Gordon Gibson, Swansea's Dylan Gallagher, Stirling's Chris Muir, Loughborough's Calvin Fry, Stirling's Salvador Gordo, in 7, Plymouth's Freddie Ashley Sparks. In 8, Tom Robertson. And in 9, Stirling's Riccardo Lucarelli. And there they all are. There's confirmation of your lineup. This is the B final, 100 butterfly. It'll take a little while to go over that 800 metre race. 200ths of a second separating. And they both broke the previous Bucks record. Remarkable. Right. 100 butterfly. B final. Chris Muir was the 11th fastest man this morning. 54.85. Always got to be one that misses out on the medal final. Quickest away is Calvin Fry, though. Representing Loughborough. And the horns are back out. Which means Birmingham are in the field. And it's Sam Pyefinch in lane zero. Calvin Fry, Loughborough, looking quality through 50. Half a second to Gordon Gibson. Just a tiny bit more to Robertson. The final 25. Calvin Fry to secure 11th place officially in the overall standings. In 2, Brody Gordon Gibson representing Edinburgh. In 6, coming back nicely, Salvador Gordo for Stirling. In towards the wall, no denying Calvin Fry, 53.41. Brody Gordon Gibson in second position. And Dylan Gallagher for Swansea takes third. He had a strong finish. In fact, Chris Muir was third place for Stirling, 54-98. Calvin Fry, Gordon Gibson, Muir, and then Gordo just missing out. He got a fourth place in the end there. Just pipped at the post. And it'll be no surprise to see the 100 metre butterfly medal final coming up next, because that is how we roll. And I do apologise, I've been off the chat for a little while just because those races have been so good. Let's welcome our medal finalists in the 100 fly open category. From lane zero, Edinburgh's Callum Rose. Stirling in one with Peter Allen. Stirling in two with Andrew Bertolli. Edinburgh in three, Tom Carswell. In lane number four, you're going to find Bath Josh Gammon. In five, Loughborough's Ruben Rowbotham-Keating. In lane six, representing Swansea, Lewis Fraser. In seven, for Sheffield Hallam, Aaron Fox. In lane number eight, Swansea's Antonio Rodriguez. And in nine, you saw there, Stirling's Josh Press. Record set in 2021, Andreas Vizeos 50.13. I think that might stand for some time. Josh Gammon was quickest this morning, 52.4, representing Bath. He was a second quicker than Ruben Rowbotham-Keating, representing Loughborough. Quick start for Lewis Fraser for Swansea, though. He's in lane number six. In four, Josh Gammon. He'll be up there at halfway. But it'll be Fraser, Gammon, Carswell, Fox. Right. Big contrast in who comes out of the water first. But lane six, Lewis Fraser for Swansea. Can he upset the apple cart here? Because in four, Josh Gammon trails by about a third of a body length, going towards the wall. And Swansea and Lewis Fraser are going to take this one. 50.98. An absolutely rapid time for gold. Josh Gammon will get a silver for Bath, and a bronze will go the way of Ruben Rowbotham-Keating for Loughborough, 52-21. A sub 51 though, Lewis Fraser for Swansea. That is a superb time, and much quicker than every single heat time this morning. Saving the best for the final. And we've had the open, now we go to the female butterfly 100 B final and medal final. Athletes emerging for our B final. Can you believe this, right? We are now halfway through our schedule in this final session. And what an afternoon we are having. From lane zero, you're going to have Bath's Ekaterina Price, Stirling's Maddie Robertson, Salford's Jessica Calderbank, Edinburgh's Kira Schloschen. No, you're not. Wrong race. It's got to happen once, hasn't it? That was the A final. In the B final, it is Faith Yuda for Edinburgh, Imara Bell-Thorpe for Edinburgh, Millie Scotchbrook for Liverpool, King's College's Lindsay Reeve, Chloe Harris for Edinburgh, Catherine Ilian for Swansea, Georgia Gussie for Marchant, Hetty Damassa for Manchester Metropolitan, Jessica Dixon, Swansea, and Katie Baxter, Bath. The races were going so quick, I was a race ahead of myself. This is the B final. Chloe Harris, a 102.29, got her lane four in our B final. In six, Georgia Gussie for Marchant. And just got an eye here on lane number three as well, Lindsay Reeve. And in one, Imrabella Thorpe. Harris, Gussie and Reeve are your top three, but you've got to say all 10 in this one with about 35 metres to swim. But moving on, Chloe Harris for Edinburgh just missed out on the medal final. She'll want to pick up a win here. Georgia Gussie in second place right now. Catherine Ealing of Swansea might have a word to say about that, as will Lindsay Reeve for King's College in three. And in fact, in five, Catherine Ealing might come back and win this one. She does. My word. What a final 25 metres for Swansea's Catherine Ealing. 101.57 takes it away from Chloe Harris by 1/100th of a second. What is happening tonight? And then 101.65, Georgia Gussie for Marchant. She was 7/100ths further back. 8/100ths of a second separating your top three. Loving this, I'm sure you are too, wherever you're watching from. So the competitors will grab their kits from the boxes behind the starters blocks. And once it's clear, we will welcome, as we will right now, finalists in the female 100 metre butterfly. This is for medals. Leading the march into the starting blocks in lane zero, Bath's Ekaterina Price. In one for Stirling, Maddie Robertson. In two, representing Salford, Jessica Calderbank. In three for Edinburgh, Kira Schloschen. In four, Stirling's Lucy Grieve. In five for Stirling again, this time Kiana McInnes. In six for Loughborough, Laura Stevens. In seven, representing Cardiff, Duru Tanir. In eight, Loughborough's Camelia Fidkovic. And in nine, Loughborough, Harriet Rogers. She looked calm, didn't she, Harriet Rogers? Lucy Grieve, 57.35 earlier today, and Kiana McInnes, 58.63. Your Bucks record set by Louise Hansen, none other, in 2021, 56.39. Is that on the cards? They'll have to go a second quicker than the Heat. Early starter, Lucy Grieve leads by 1/13 over Stevens, McInnes, Fidkovic and Schloschen. and she'll grow that lead through the third length to her left-hand side. If she were to look, she'd see McKenna McInnes and Laura Stevens in sync together as they turn. And in three, Kira Schloschen for Edinburgh. They are going to be fighting for silver and bronze, because leading the way towards the line, Lucy Grieve, a 57 on the button and a gold medal. What a swim. Kiana McInnes, her teammate, to sterling gold and silver, 58-29. And in bronze, Laura Stevens of Loughborough, and the sterling teammates embrace in the centre of the pool, and so they should. The sterling masterclass in the 100 fly. Lucy Grieve, Kiana McInnes, Laura Stevens confirmed in venue. Gold, silver and bronze. Kira Schloschen just missing out. Keep those messages coming in on the YouTube chat box. A request here for a shout out for Johnny Beck. It's his 18th birthday, from Ronnie Hallett. Any messages? And do you know what? I can't do the research. Whatever you say, I'll assume you're being correct and honest and sincere. Unless it's clearly a bit of a duke. Let's move on. 50 metre races now, four of them, all breaststroke, B finals and medal finals. If it really is Johnny Beck's birthday, happy birthday, welcome to adulthood, 18. Just don't party until tomorrow night. You've got a big day tomorrow. In this B final, Alex Mayer for Stirling, Cameron White for Nottingham, Andrew Arthur for Stirling, Jacob Armand, Swansea, Charlie Trotman, Edinburgh, Gordon Lee, Brunel, Olivier Vedren, East Anglia, George Barnes, King's College, Usain Cook, Edinburgh, and Louis Weeks in nine representing Bath. This will take around about 28 seconds. Nothing to separate them in the first 25 metres. Oh, we've got a stopper in lane number seven. But we carry on. Lane number three, Jacob Armand representing Swansea. Going to battle towards the wall with Charlie Trotman and Gordon Lee in four and five. Or can it come from elsewhere? This could be any lane. Jacob Armand takes it for Swansea, 27-89. Gordon Lee, 28-16. That might be the first time Jacob Armand's gone sub-28. In which case, well done, Mr. Armand and Team Swansea. Third place for Usain Cook. Unfortunately, George Barnes stopping at 25 metres. Still in the pool right now. Having a chat with some colleagues and officials, I think. Hopefully all okay, though. We won't start the final until he is. And coming up in just a second, that 50 breast final. That has a record which goes back to 2018. None other than James Wilby set it in a 58.07. Right, I'm not going to read out these messages on the YouTube chat, because I've no idea if you're telling the truth or not. I got messages about 17th birthdays, becoming a father. I was a student too, I know what you like. That's the type of thing I would write as a joke. But just in case, happy birthday and congratulations. I'm going to cover all angles here. Right then, stop laughing, this is serious. 50 metre breaststroke final. Although we can't start yet because George Barnes is still in the pool. Let's give the names out. Lane zero, Pravin Mahendra Kumar for Southampton. Alex Cahoon, Loughborough in one. Greg Butler for Loughborough in lane number two. Paniatis Panaratos for Swansea is in lane number three. Sam Neill for Birmingham is in lane four. There come the Hooters. Archie Goodburn for Edinburgh is going to be in lane number five. In six, Sheffield Hallam's Rowan Smith. In seven and eight, it's going to be Stirling teammates. First, Rory Dixon. And in lane eight, Rafe Dobson. And in lane number nine, in the very colourful swim shorts, Cardiff Mets' Connor Bryant. So I can thankfully say George Barnes is okay, out of the water and walking. So we can continue with this 50 breast final. Again, the 50 breast record set by James Wilby, 26.74. Just about half a second off that Sam Neill earlier today in 27.26. Okay, two lengths off the pool. And Sam Neill for Birmingham already leads, even just through the dive. The quality is that high. To his right-hand side, now on the way back, Archie Goodburn. Edinburgh is going to make the charge of the rest of the field in six. Rowan Smith for Sheffield Hallam. It's going to be a two-man race towards the wall. Neill, Goodburn, Birmingham, Edinburgh. Who takes it? Archie Goodburn. A gold medal in 26.92. Just outside the Bucks record, but for the time being, that won't matter. He's a Bucks champion in the short course 2023. Sam Neill, who led until the final few metres for Birmingham, 27.03 silver. And Paniatis Panaratos is a bronze medalist. More 50 metres coming up in the female 50 breast. B final and medal final, that's next. B finalists from lane zero, Cambridge's Rebecca Keatley, Bath's Emily Morgan Hughes, Stirling's Victoria Russell, Nottingham's Megan SNG, Edinburgh's Olwyn Cook, Harriet Watts' Hannah Bowley, Birmingham's Nellie Clark, Edinburgh's Louise Edmonds, Glasgow's Gigi Slater, and Leeds' Kirsten Harvey. Racing for 11th to 20th in the official standings. The best start here has actually come from lane number two, Victoria Russell representing Stirling. She'll be lead at the halfway mark. It doesn't mean too much in 50 metre racing, we've seen that already tonight, but she rises first on the way back too. In one to her side, inspired, Emily Morgan Hughes representing Bath, then in the green cap in three for Nottingham, Megan SNG, or coming back in four, Owen Cook for Edinburgh. This is right across the pool, but Emily Morgan Hughes for Bath takes it, 31.95. That's a quick time. And Olwyn Cook, great second 25 metres for second place. Victoria Russell, early leader, settles for fourth because Nellie Clark came through for Birmingham to nab third place from lane number six. the athletes will just clear the pool, grab their belongings from behind the starting blocks, and we'll welcome our 50 breast medal finalists. Leading the way, that is in lane zero, Hannah Woodcock for Swansea. In one for Birmingham, Lucy Canavan. In two, representing Loughborough, Sienna Robinson. In three, representing Loughborough, it is Sophie Hansen. In four, representing Stirling, fastest this morning, Agarad Evans. In five, representing Loughborough, Tatiana Bolonagoff. She's the Bucks record holder. In six, representing Edinburgh, Cara Hanlon. In seven, her teammates for Edinburgh, Katie Goodburn. In eight, representing Edinburgh, Napier, Anna Morgan. And in nine, representing Swansea, Camelia Stoymanova. The Bucks record holder is Bolonagoff. She's in lane five. It was 29.45 she set last year. She's the reigning Buck short course champion. But Angerad Evans for Stirling went 15 hundredths quicker in the heats this morning. Can Tatiana retain her title? Will it be taken away? Will there be a new Bucks record? We've had plenty. Good start in seven for Katie Goodburn of Edinburgh. But in three, Sophie Hansen of Loughborough. She will turn home for first. This could be across five lanes right now with 10 metres to swim. Angerad Evans and Tatiana Bolonagoff with a little bit of work to do, with the clinic coming back in the last 5 metres. But in three, Sophie Hansen representing Loughborough. 29.53, just outside a Bucks record, but a gold medal. Tatiana Bolonagoff representing Loughborough, 29.75. And Agarad Evans for Stirling, 30.06. Sophie Hansen, confirmed in venue, gold medal for Loughborough, 29.53. She was 0.08 of a second outside the Bucks record. And now the 200 metre backstroke. And I'm just getting a report. In fact, that time was potentially a new Bucks record in the 50 breaststroke final. I'll get confirmation of that. If so, another one falls. So B final, 200 backstroke. Archie Evans for Bath, Andrew Brodie for Edinburgh, Dominic Morgan for Swansea, Toby Hill, Manchester Metropolitan, Jack Skerry for Bath, his teammate Robbie Hemmings next door in five, Charlie Broome leads Beckett, Jamie Ferguson for Aberdeen, Harry Peat for Lancaster, and Lucas Brain representing Stirling is in lane number nine. this morning. 2:01s with the times set by Skerry and Hemmings for Bath in the middle. 2:01:08 and 2:01:68. Let's not split hairs. The Bath boys in the middle. Just a few tenths off getting into a medal final, in fact. Charlie Broome for Leeds Beckett will lead towards the halfway mark. In 4 and 5, Jack Skerry and Robbie Hemmings, in fact, they're going to pretty much join him. Let's be perfectly honest, the entire pool are going to join him. Only 0.8 of a second between the top six, 2 seconds to spread across the entire 10. Lane number one, Andrew Brodie for Edinburgh. In the purple shorts, just at the bottom of your screen there. Sometimes difficult to see on the angle exactly who is just in front, but he and Jack Skerry for Bath are going to turn pretty much side by side. Yeah, 0.03 of a second. Then Broome, Ferguson and Hill all within pretty much a second of your leader, Skerry. So a six-man race with 25 metres to swim, and Jack Skerry now has just moved ahead ever so slightly. Back comes Charlie Broome for Leeds Beckett, who's going to be officially the 11th fastest then. It will be Jack Skerry, 1:59.14. Oh, if he'd done that this morning, he would have been in the final. Second place for Charlie Broome and Leeds Beckett. And Jamie Ferguson for Aberdeen, 2 minutes and 33 hundredths. Follows the B final, a medal final. And there's a big record for this one. I'll bring that to you ever so shortly as part of the race content. And we are just awaiting welcoming our athletes to the starting blocks. Here they come. Your finalists then, representing Stirling in zero, Zach Speakman. In one, representing Swansea, Oscar Barlow. In two, Loughborough's Nathan Whiffin. In three is Loughborough teammate Connor Ferguson. In four, from Bath, Cam Brooker. In five, Birmingham's Oliver Morgan. In six, Edinburgh's Jordan McPhail. In lane number seven, representing Bath, Hendrik Vander. In eight, Nottingham Trent, Charlie Brown. And in nine, representing Sheffield, Sam Greenbank. Another gold medal up for grabs over the next couple of minutes. Quick start, no shock from Cam Brooker. A 157.94 was his time. Earlier on today, the Bucks record is a 153 set by Luke Greenbank back in 2018. And a body length lead for Brooker. But look at the rest of the field. Look at down the bottom there, Zach Speakman for Sterling in zero. And in lane number three, that's Connor Ferguson, Loughborough. In one, Oscar Barlow, Swansea. And in the red cap in five, Oliver Morgan of Birmingham, second fastest this morning. But they are chasing right now. Behind Brooker, Morgan, Speakman, Ferguson, Barlow. They're separated by just 0.7 of a second, those four. Or McPhail make it 0.8 of a second. But they are that distance and more behind your leader. Look at this, it's just continuing to grow here. The race for silver. Every single swimmer is potentially a medalist here. Behind Brooker. Wow, this could be hundredths of a second deciding whether you're on the podium or not. But Cam Brooker, surely he can't beat the time of 1:53 set by Greenback back in 2018. He's going to have a very good go at it. It's one of the longest standing records on the Bucks books. But Cam Brooker, representing Bath, is going to push it all the way to the line. It's a 152.8. He has done it. It's a five-year record. It's fallen to Cam Brooker, the man from Bath. Gold record and Bucks record goes again. These short course championships leaving us breathless up in the commentary and announcing box. Ollie Morgan, silver. Connor Ferguson, bronze. Cam Brooker, 152.8. New Bucks record. Takes the title away from Luke Greenbank, who set it in 2018. That is what you call dominance in an event. And on then to our female backstroke races. B final, first up. You're going to see from lane zero, Charlotte Harris for Birmingham in lane zero. Katie Bamara of Swansea in one. Lucy Block for Surrey in two. Amy Shields for Edinburgh in three. Madeline Soper for Nottingham in four. Iona Colbert in five for Edinburgh. Nottingham's Illy Woolard in six. East Anglia's Megan Pye in seven. Cardiff's Rosie Domican in eight. And in nine, Bath's Neve Pantony. About 2.25 minutes to wrap this one up. 2:15s from Madeline Soper, 2:16 Iona Colbert. But the story of the day, or the afternoon, is that in the final, you go just a little bit faster, just a couple of percent performance gets eked out from somewhere. Soper, Colbert, Shields. Block up there too. 17 hundredths between your top four. And they're pretty much synchronized swimming here. In lane six, Izzy Woolard. And then from 5-4, three and two. Going to reach the halfway mark. And Amy Shields for Edinburgh. She will have the slimmest of margins gained as they turn at the halfway stage. Soper, Block, Woolard and Colbert all within a second still. It's a five-woman race here right now. Can Megan Pye of East Anglia get involved? She's the quickest of the rest. In fact, in nine, Lee Paintney of Bath. But 5-8 in front. And one more time, out and back, to decide your B final winner. Amy Shields of Edinburgh, a third of a second advantage. And then Iona Colbert of Edinburgh, where she leads Madeline Soper right now. And is this order settled? Or can Iona Colbert come back and take second? She might, you know. Surely can't catch the leader in the last few metres. Now it's going to go all the way to Amy Shields, B final winner, 2:13.31. Iona Colbert just come back and just nab second place from Madeline Soper. And fourth is Izzy Woolard for Nottingham, 2:15.31. And no surprise at all, pretty much every one of those girls quicker than they were in the heats today. And you've got every right just to lean back and take in some oxygen, although she looks like she's hasn't swum at all. Medals on the line next. And we are just five races from, seven races from home. Yeah. Yeah, three more individual events and then some team relays to close things out. First up though, 200 back, female medal final from Lane Zero representing Edinburgh. Lucy Hitchin in one, Stirling's Nelly Kinch in two for Loughborough, Rachel Anderson in three for Bath, Neve Ward in four for Loughborough, Honey Osrin in five, Stirling's Holly McGill in six, representing Manchester, Sophie Shaw. In seven, Stirling's Caitlin Ebbage. In eight, Swansea's Scarlett Major. And in nine, representing Edinburgh, Ellis Shields. Metre backstroke final. Box record 2:05.33. That was Catherine Greenslade representing Edinburgh in 2017. Honey Osrin for Loughborough, a 2:08.07 earlier on today, and she was 2 seconds quicker than anybody else. She is our hot favourite. Holly McGill of Stirling was the closest. But look at this. Just through 50 metres already. And just making her presence felt. Just a couple of tenths to McGill, Shaw and Ward. Half a second plus to the rest of the field. She is at the tip of the arrow through 75. And it was 1700s through 50 metres. Holly McGill are keeping a really close check on her though. The rest of the pool as we spread out to the outer lanes. Just falling back ever so slightly. It's now 0.6 of a second to McGill and over a second to Ward, Shaw, Anderson and Major. And she'll have to do this one more time out and back. And Holly McGill is going to keep her extremely honest. Third place right now in three, Neve Ward for Bath. And she has got a massive battle on her hands with Rachel Anderson of Loughborough. And in lane six, Sophie Shaw of Manchester. Let's jump back to the front, turning for home then. It is Honey Alter in for Loughborough. Holly McGill, she's been chasing the entire 200 metres, but she's going to come up just short because Honey Alterin is going to close the door on this one. It's a 205.7 gold medalist. Silver for Holly McGill and a bronze for Neve Ward. Alterin just outside the Bucks record too. I didn't think they'd get that close. Her heat time was 208.07. Her final time, 205.7. So she did have something left in the tank after the heat. She went all out for it and she came up just under 0.4 short of the Bucks record. That doesn't matter, that's secondary. She's most importantly Bucks champion in the 200 back for 2023 short course. And now, straight into our fastest heat in the 400 metre individual medley open competition. This is heat four, but it is effectively our final. In lane zero, Swansea's Oscar Barlow. In one, Loughborough's Reuben Rowbotham Keating. In two for Loughborough, Ben Harrison. In three for Stirling, George Smith. In four, representing Stirling, Evan Jones. In five, Loughborough's Charlie Hutchinson. In six, Loughborough, already had a good weekend so far, Dan Whiffin. In seven, Stirling's Angus Allison. In eight, Stirling's Pierce Greening. And in nine, for Bath, Isaac Dodds. Actually got no Lane Southern, so no Angus Allison. The Bucks record, another standout name, and Bucks alumni, Duncan Scott, 2019 for Stirling, a 4.06.00. Evan Jones is the fastest on paper, just missing in fact the entry times though for this race, unfortunately. I'll see if I can find it somewhere. Everybody's going to be sub 4:20 because heat number three, the fastest time in heat number three was a 4:20. So we've got 10 swimmers quicker than that. And in fact, 4:22 was the fastest time from heat number 3. So officially this is a heat declared winner event. This is heat number 4, but the fastest 10 swimmers are in here. So they've got to beat 4:22.32 to be medalists. They're all capable of that. And it's that Bucks record within reach. Duncan Scott is 4 years old, that record. And right now, Charlie Hutchison leads the way over Evan Jones. And in one, Reuben Roboth and Keating. And lane number 6, you've got Dan Whiff in here. He's a long distance specialist. He had 800 metres and 1500 this week already. Gold in both, Bucks record in both. But this one, early doors, looking to be just out of his reach. Maybe he's, I mean, to be fair, he's done enough already, hasn't he? He could not swim again and you'd be all right with your performance and your weekend's work. Charlie Hutchison, 1:59.82. It's a halfway. Of course, breaststroke will slow things down slightly. Evan Jones for Stirling, fastest on paper, second in the pool. And then still Reuben Roboth and Keating for Loughborough. Fourth place right now is Dan Whiffin. But he's got competition to his left and right. But the three men looking at medals right now are away 4 or 5 seconds on the rest of the pack. So we might just be looking at this one. That's Charlie Hutchison, Evan Jones and Reuben Roboth and Keating. They're going to come back and have a 50 metre shootout on the freestyle. 100 metres, I said that earlier, 100 metre shootout on the freestyle. And Charlie Hutchison will lead them out as he has done through 300 metres thus far. Evan Jones, 1.5 seconds back, and Reuben Roboth and Keating just a few extra metres beyond the top two. But the top three is absolutely wrapped up. Nobody's going to challenge for the gold, silver, bronze here. They're that far ahead. It's a good 10, 15 metres. Even the best of Dan Whiffin can't close that gap. So let's concentrate at the front then. Charlie Hutchison, 1.4 seconds clear of Jones and 3 seconds clear of Roboth and Keating. The Bucks record of 4:06 looks pretty safe. But gold medal on the line here. And Charlie Hutchison has led from the off. A body length advantage into the last few metres over Evan Jones from Stirling. Coming back in one is Reuben Roboth and Keating. It's going to be 2 Loughborough on the podium, but standing on the top step, Charlie Hutchison, a 4:09.62, cracking time, sub 4:10. Evan Jones, silver, had it in the bag, pretty much from 350 metres out, held on. Reuben Roboth and Keating was chasing, and he got within a couple of tenths of a second in the end, and takes a bronze. Big smiles. Naughty boy, never go out over the timing pads, always by the side of the pool. We'll let him off, gold medalist. You do what you want. And finally we get confirmed times. I was just getting a bit twitchy there. Confirmed times in the venue. Hutchison, Jones, Roboth and Keating, 4:09.62, gold medal time. And that is actually the last individual event for our open competition, the men's. And we'll just now have the female 400 metre individual medley. And to close out the session, we have 4x50 freestyle relays. It's the only way to end a final session, with a relay. And here they come, the last individual race for our girls tonight. 400 IM, In lane 0, representing Swansea, Rachel Hornby. In 1 for Bath, Anna Farrow. In 2, Queen's Margaret, Ailsa McDonald. In 3, Lily Booker from Loughborough. In 4, Katie Shanahan representing Stirling. All these names we know well. Freya Colbert in 5 for Loughborough. In 6, Sheffield Hallam's Abigail Miles. In 7, representing Edinburgh, Lara Thompson. In 8, Sheffield Hallam, Caris O'Reilly. And in 9, representing Swansea, Laura Sharp. That's your lineup for the 400 IM final. The Bucks record for the 400 IM is one of the longest standing ones, set in 2015 by none other than Amy Wilmot, representing East London at the time. It's a 4:31.77 Commonwealth Games gold medalist and international performer. Amy Wilmot worked with her a couple of times. Quite a good commentator too, Amy Wilmot. I say quite good, that's rude. Very good commentator, Amy Wilmot. And Katie Shanahan and Freya Colbert, they are long-time rivals. I say long-time, they're both quite young, but they've spent a lot of time competing against each other in Bucks Championships. This is the likes of Lily Booker. Look at these two go. Colbert behind or ahead of Shanahan. Not just individual rivalry, but university rivalry too. Stirling and Loughborough always up there. I think of the Bucks records, if you went through them, there's probably around about 50, 60 box records. And of the 60, let's just say 60 for the time being, 50 or 55 are either Loughborough or Stirling. They've dominated these championships, short course and long course. Katie Shanahan, Freya Colbert now side by side. So, we're at the halfway stage. So, who has the better breaststroke? They literally rise out the water at pretty much the same time. Oh, in fact, Freya Colbert's cadence is a bit quicker. However, with the longer strokes, Katie Shanahan is moving ahead. Technique, so obviously critically important, but there are definitely more than one way of doing things. I saw a video on Instagram yesterday. I forget the name of the swimmer, but they swam a 50 meter length of a pool with a mug of hot chocolate on their head and it didn't spill. Solid as a rock, that stroke in the water. Smooth as silk. Can you be solid as a rock and smooth as silk? Don't know, what would that be? And Katie Shanahan on the breaststroke. She starts to move away. A body length and some change. Back to Freya Colbert now. Again, that record, which is pretty solid. Of Amy Wilmot. 4:31. Let's ignore that for the time being. Let's just concentrate on the gold medal and the order here. I should mention, back in third place, apologies, Lily Booker for Loughborough. And she's potentially going to chase Frey Colbert here. It's not going to have it easy for that silver medal by any means, Frey Colbert. But Katie Shanahan just looks to be getting stronger and stronger. And the lead now is going to be close to 5 seconds. It is, it's 3.8, not as far as it looks in the water. And then just a couple more back to Booker. But it's looking pretty set in stone now, these top three. Katie Shanahan, Freya Colbert, Lily Booker. You'll be in that order. 4.31. Do you know what? That record from 2015, it's going to be not far away at all. Just outside, maybe. Oh my goodness. So close, just outside by a couple of tenths, but it's a gold medal, a superb swim from Katie Shanahan, Freya Colbert silver, and Lily Booker the bronze. It was always going to be those three really from about 200 metres onwards. Katie Shanahan, 4.31.93, so close to Amy Wilmot's record, but doesn't get it despite that. Bucks champion again in the short course in the 400 individual medley, and she'll stand onto the top step of the podium as she has done many times before at the end of the session as part of our presentation ceremony. Well done, Katie Shanahan, and congrats Freya Colbert, Lily Booker. More medals in the bag for yourselves and Loughborough. Getting confirmation on the chat here. Thank you. It wasn't hot chocolate. It was a chocolate milkshake. Do you know what? That is a lot more sensible, actually. And Katie Ledecky, yeah, you're absolutely bang on. If you haven't seen it, just jump on Google or Instagram and look for Katie Ledecky chocolate milkshake. It is remarkable. It doesn't move a millimetre. And if there's anything you don't want to spill in a pool to arouse suspicion, it's got to be chocolate milkshake, hasn't it? And it was brave. A cup of water would have been fine. Right, that is all of our individual races done. We are now in relay territory. Officially event 4.29 in the books. But it's the 4x50 freestyle team relay. Just a question from Rich. Finally, a sensible question. Thank you, Rich, in the YouTube chat. I've been watching, but what does she do with it? She sticks it on her head and swims 50 metres, and it literally doesn't move. It's... Right. Let's get serious. 4x50 freestyle relay. Men up first in the V final. We are going to see. Oh, look at this. Flags and towels being waved. They are proud. We have got from lane zero, Oxford, Leeds, Glasgow, Durham, Birmingham 2, Warwick, Sheffield Hallam 2, Surrey, Bucksnew, and King's College. They're all getting ready. Four per team. 50 metres each, 200 total distance, and this is fighting for 11th to 20th in the orders. We're going to see four of these B and A finals for the open and the female to close out evening number two. Jason Mamatoglu, King's College, is set off hard. A couple of lanes inside in seven, Ewan Taylor for Surrey. In five, Gabriel Foo for Warwick. And in three, Lucas Dyson-Diaz is representing Birmingham. But that's quick for Mamatoglu, 22 and a half seconds, opening leg. Between Southern, Louis Mitchell, sorry, Sachin, Dan Stevens for Surrey has taken over. And they may lead now in five, James LeGrice for Warwick now. They'll lead at the halfway stage. Leg number three swimmers coming in. Everything to play for. It is still Warwick over Surrey. Now everybody's here now. I can't even say university names because everybody's involved. Birmingham coming back. That'll cause a roar. Sheffield Hallam in 6-2. But leading the way, Alex Armstrong hangs over for Surrey onto the anchor leg. 110.75 with 50 metres to swim. B final's a cracker. Still leading Surrey into the final 25 metres. Fabian Brudnicki, quality swimmer to have on your final leg in 4. Sam Pyfinch for Birmingham in 6. It's Jack Stretton for Sheffield Hallam. Into the wall they go. You won't take it away from Surrey though. 133.58. Birmingham takes second in 134.42. And then Glasgow. Excellent. Setting us up nicely for the medal final. It'll take a little bit longer to let all the guys collect all their gear. The box record for reference in the 4x50 free is 126.43. That belongs to Sterling. They got that in 2019. And then they've had Duncan Scott as a member of that team. It would have been a pretty scary lineup for Sterling then. Now let's race for medals. From lane zero, look at them all, 40 athletes. Leeds Beckett in zero, in lane one, Sterling team two. In lane two, Edinburgh. In lane three, Swansea. In four, Birmingham one. In five, Sterling one. Six, Sheffield Hallam 1, in 7, Loughborough, in 8, Bath, and in 9, St Andrews. Fastest team on paper here, Birmingham, and they will make a lot of noise. They're going to be led out by Sam Neild in lane number 4. Also in that team, Adrian Ting, Ping Chi Lau, and Oliver Morgan. Sterling, the Bucks record holders. They are led out by Brogan Hyde with Rory Dixon, Andrew Batoli and Evan Jones on the anchor leg. Loughborough, only six fastest qualifiers with Calvin Fry, Alex Cahoon, Michael Ripper and Tyler Melbourne-Smith. Sheffield Hallam in lane six. They'll be led out by Aaron Fox. Are you ready for this one? So many people hanging over the barriers here, getting shots of this. That's what they're here for. And the women's will be exactly the same. It's like a whitewater rapids in the pool. through the first 25 metres. If you've got some washing, throw it in now, you've got it cleaned up. In two, Tom Caswell for Edinburgh, and in seven, Calvin Fry for Loughborough. It's Loughborough that lead from lane seven. Brogan Hyde and Sam Neill hand over for Stirling and Birmingham in fourth and fifth in the centre lanes. Loughborough continue to lead the way through 75 metres. Likewise, Edinburgh, Archie Goodburn down in lane number two. Who's put the strong swimmers in the later legs? Lane three, crack on two, having a good time. Max Elkin handing over it for Swansea. But Loughborough lead, look at lane number eight, that's Bath. Rob Derbyshire handed over. And in lane number two, Edinburgh, it's Luke Shaw. Josh Gammon in the water for Bath in eight. Here we go then. It is Loughborough take the advantage into the anchor leg. In eight, Josh Gammon handed over for Bath. They're going to race all the way back in lanes two and three here. Luke Shaw and Matthew Burton for Edinburgh, and Swansea have handed over to Kempster and Fraser. Back they come then towards the wall. There's four teams in this one. There's Loughborough, there's Bath, there's Edinburgh and Swansea. And he goes to Loughborough. 1:28.06. It's a phenomenal time. What a race. Breathless. Bath take the silver, 1:28.21, and Edinburgh the bronze, 1:28.41, 0.3 of a second, there or thereabouts, separating your top three. Relay racing at its best. Swansea just missing out on a medal. And we're going to close the show with the female B final and final. I've no doubt at all they will live up to that hype. And what a day it's been. Again, just a short break whilst we get 40 swimmers make space for 40 more to come in. Watching our home today or in your dorms, wherever you might be, and you're coming to join us tomorrow, we can't wait to see you. We kick off from 8:30 tomorrow morning, a little bit earlier with our heats, and then the session today runs very similarly to what we've had this morning, this afternoon and into this evening. I'll bring you completely up to speed just before we close the show, which will only be around about 10 minutes time away. Two more races to come. Both 4x50s, both for the girls. And our 10 teams line up. We have got Nottingham 2, Exeter, Northumbria 1, Surrey, Manchester Met, Manchester, Leeds, Birmingham 2, East Anglia and Durham. In lane number 4, Rebecca Amor will lead out Manchester Met. And their city rivals Manchester, next door in 5, led out by Abigail Parkinson. First to rise out the water, Amelia Peters representing Leeds. Inseparable through 25 metres. Who's had a good turn here? Emma Flannery has for Northumbria in two. Likewise, Abigail Parkinson for Manchester. They'll hand over for leg two. Cooley, Amor and Peters handed over for their respective unis in third, fourth and fifth. Only a second separating the top seven teams in five and six. Sophie Shaw for Manchester, Abigail Jolly for Leeds. In lane number four, Hetty Damasa for Manchester Met. They're your three leaders. In two and three, Katie Stubbs for Northumbrian out. And Macy Thornton, Surrey, halfway stage. Jolly, Damasa, Shaw, Thornton, Stubbs. Forrest as well in lane nine for Durham. Top five, only 1 second separating in the water in four. Izzy Goodwin for Manchester Met. Lily Mae Maston for Manchester. And Louise Brooks for Leeds. They're your front three. In lane three, Zoe Musial for Surrey, having lots to say in seven. Great swim from Larissa Dean for Birmingham, getting them right back into this fight. Two up front now. It's Manchester Met and Manchester. They'll fight for the B final win. Pride of the city on the line. It is Molly Garrett for Manchester Met, Amy West for Manchester, and the former, can she bring it home and take the B final? Yes, she can. 146-21, 1300s clear of Manchester. And then Surrey take this third place ahead of Leeds, who came back strong on the final leg with Kirsten Harvey. But it's the team of Rebecca Amor, Hetty Damasa, Izzy Goodwin and Molly Garrett who will take the win in the B final. Congrats, girls. Manchester second, Surrey third, those confirmed in the venue. We have one more race. And there will be four golds, four silvers, four bronzes available. Fourth and final, 4x50. Clear the starting blocks in just a few moments time. Our medal final teams will take to the stage to close our show on day two here at Ponds Forge. The Bucks Short Course Swimming Championships. One more day to come tomorrow, start at 8:30. But for the time being, we've got about 1 minute 45 of Bedlam to come. In lane zero, down the bottom of your screen, it is Team Nottingham, led out by Izzy Lee. In one, Sheffield Hallam, led out by Avril Bowler. In two, Stirling One, led out by Josephine Klein. In three, Team Bath, Neve Ward will lead. Loughborough in four, Cornelia Fidkovic. In five, Swansea's Amy Monks will get them going. In six, Edinburgh's Drew McKenzie has the baton on leg number one. In seven, Birmingham one, Laura McNadd giving the nod for leg one. Stirling two in lane number eight, Evie Davis in charge. And lane nine, Aberdeen, Mary Mishenko will head them out through the first 50 metres. Let's do it then. Final race of the day. Giving it a good go on the horn. Oh, Birmingham, that'll be screaming for lane number seven here. Quick start in four. Kolinia Fidkovic of Loughborough over in eight. Evie Davis representing Stirling, the big rivals. In five, Swansea's Amy Monks And in six, Drew McKenzie for Edinburgh. But look at the lead for Loughborough on the second leg. It's going to be Harriet Rogers. The Bucks record in the 4x50 freestyle is 138.38, set by Loughborough last year. That's a quick time, 6 seconds slower, the official entry times here. But lane four, Loughborough lead into leg three. Over in lane number eight, Lucy Grieve hands over for Sterling. She'll hand over to Kiana McInnes. In third place in the pool, Bath, Maisie Guildford hands over to Anna Farrow for leg number three. But they've got a big job ahead of them. For doing so, Sterling are having an effort at this. And if you want anybody giving it a go, Kiana McInnes would be one of those. Lane four, Loughborough head eight. Final anchor leg, and it's Freya Colbert, the formidable Freya Colbert, will lead them home. But look out in lane number eight, Katie Shanahan, already having a great weekend. She's been put in charge of closing the gap. She has closed it to a body length. In lane number three, it's Bath and Jemima Hall, and in six, Katie Goodburn for Edinburgh. But nobody will take the win away from Loughborough. 139.3, gold medalists again in the 4x50. A silver for Sterling, brought it home, a 140.9. And Bath, an admirable bronze, 141.84. What a way to end the show. But the team of Loughborough, Fidkovic, Rogers, De Groot and Colbert, unbeatable. Results are confirmed in venue. A big, big hug between the Loughborough teammates. They knew, would have known they were favourites. You've still got to do it, though. And that makes the pressure even harder when it's expected. But they performed and they delivered. And that, folks, is day two. We're done. Did you enjoy yourselves? You don't need to answer. I know it was a yes. And it's been a joy to bring it to you from the commentary position up here at Ponds Forge as well. Now, we do have the medal ceremonies to come along. But for racing, that's just completed. So if you want to watch the ceremonies, give us 5 or so minutes and you'll be able to hear the announcer here in the venue reading those dates, so you can enjoy their celebrations with them. But for the time being, from myself and the commentary box here at Ponds Forge International Sports Centre, a big thank you to all of our officials, referees, volunteers, timekeepers, athletes, spectators and you at home watching. This is the Bucks Short Course Swimming Championship 2023. Day two, our Saturday, is completed. Tomorrow, 8:30, we do it for one more final time. Three sessions, all ending with the finals from 10 past 3pm. Have a great evening. Enjoy your night. We'll see you tomorrow morning.